those of you who have been at Targeting Autism forums previously or have searched the web for online library type training are probably familiar with Dr. Ruth Small of Project Enable out of Syracuse. Part of the current grant has been for Project Enable to expand their online autism related modules. So today we have with us Katie McGinnis, and I think, are you a master's student or PhD?
Master's.
Master's, okay.
Not there yet.
Katie's a grad student at Syracuse in the master's program working with Dr. Ruth, not the Dr. Ruth TV fan, in launching the Project Enable modules for autism as part of the Targeting Autism project. She studied art education for her undergraduate, and she's an art teacher at Burton Street Elementary School in Cazenovia, New York. She's going to be completing her library degree in the fall, and she's here to let everyone know what's happening with Project Enable currently. So, Katie.
Thank you. Under McGinnis TA presentation.
Oh, I thought you were going to go live.
No, just go to the presentation. Yeah, we don't need that.
I took screenshots of everything, so that's just easier. Yeah, perfect, thank you. First of all, before I start, I just want to say, and please don't tell Dr. Ruth this, but I'm so glad she couldn't come, because I am so happy to be here. I have to tell you, this presentation has, this forum has opened my eyes completely. Just coming from, I don't know, I only started on this project with Dr. Ruth about maybe 3 months ago. So I have only been just starting to learn about autism. I learned about it in college and we talked about it just so much, but oh my goodness, I wish everyone in the world could come to something like this. It's just amazing. And we really wanted to launch this program very soon. And after coming to this presentation, I feel like I want to reread through everything we did because I have new eyes. So maybe it'll be a couple more weeks. I invite you to follow along with me. If you have an electronic device, I will be going through the steps of how to access the online training. So if you would like to do that, go ahead and get out your laptops or mobile devices or iPads or anything if you'd like to. If not, again, you can just follow the steps when we share the slides. So if you don't know, Project Enable is an online training site for librarians. And a lot of people have been working on this module within Project Enable. I'm only one person that's worked on it in the last couple months. There's a lot of other people that have really been working on this for the past 2 years, and it would not have been possible without Mary, Suzanne, and Russ, who have really been our experts. Everything that we do, we send to them, and then they send us back pages upon notes that are so amazing. So thank you. So Project Enable is, it provides free foundational self-directed online training to public, academic, and school librarians. It helps them acquire knowledge and skills needed to create inclusive and accessible libraries in library programs and services. So it really is an online training program, and a lot of master's students like myself use Project Enable in our schooling, but it really can be used for any type of library, academic, public, or school. Oh, also, the only thing that's a little confusing about Project Enable is that within it, there are a bunch of different modules. Targeting Autism is specifically module 6 within Project Enable. So how will Project Enable help your library and help train your staff? Well, from our experience, Your librarians will become more sensitive to the needs of people with autism and their families. They will be better educated, better prepared, and they'll get endless supplies of resources, which I find is the number one benefit of Project Enable is that, and Targeting Autism, is that there are so many resources, which I'll get into later. So how to access this? If you go to that website, which is right there, projectenable.syr.edu, the site does make you register to access the training, but it is completely free. If you already have an account, all you have to do is log in. It's really easy to register, even though you may not have time to do it right now. I encourage you to do it later so you can explore it a little bit more. If you're doing this as like a library, you can register your library, and then you can kind of see what your librarians are learning and doing within that training site. Once you are logged in, you click on training in the menu, and then you'll click on Module 6, which is Targeting Autism. This is what the homepage looks like, and I'll just mention a couple things here. At the top, you see the blog, login, and register. So that's where you would log in and register. And also the blog is just very interesting. It's a bi-monthly blog, and Dr. Ruth Small does do a lot of writing within the blog, so I highly recommend you check that out. The training button is all the way at the corner there. And then the number one thing I want to tell you about is the resource database. Even if you don't use this training, the resource database is really, really fantastic. So for everything that we write within this training, we've collected all the resources that we use. And I've also made like a two-page document throughout these 2 days of more resources that we will add to this database of everything that I've gotten from these past 2 days. It includes over 1,000 resources. That number is old when I took the screenshot. Every day we add more and more and more and more. There are so many things, from videos to blogs to articles and books. There's just so many things. And the best thing about it is that you can search by content, you can search by grade level, keyword, and it will sort the results for you. So let's say a third grade teacher comes into your library and says, I want to teach my kids about autism because we have a new student and he's autistic and I want to welcome him into the classroom. You could search by grade 3 reading level autism, and it will bring up a bunch of books that are at a third grade reading level focused on autism. So that's how specific you can get, which is just a great resource to have in your library. So once you click on training, in the left hand menu, you'll see Module 6, Targeting Autism. Once you click on that, you will see a bunch of different topics. So within Module 6, there's 6 topics, which gets a little confusing, but topics are within the module, and each one of these topics is about as big as the module itself. There's tons of information. This is formatted so that you don't have to train in every single topic. Obviously, a lot of people already know what is autism. If your librarians have already been trained in what is autism, they might not need to go to topic 1. But let's say your librarians know nothing about employment. They could go directly to topic 6, which focuses on library support and opportunities, employment of people on the spectrum. So they could just go through topic 6 if they wish. You can jump around. They do make sense in order, but you don't necessarily have to go through every topic. Module 6, contents. Our objective is librarians will be trained on how to meet the needs of library users who have autism, including providing resources and services such as employment, community service, etc. They will learn how to develop programs for this population of the library, as well as make existing programs more inclusive. I wanted to read that because I didn't want to miss anything within that, because we really think that's very important. Every single topic has an introduction. It runs through main objectives, and it gives you main ideas, everything like that. And every topic introduction is very visually appealing. We try to not make this so heavy, so it's very easy to go through the modules. Even though it is a lot of content, it's very visually appealing, and that's a number one thing as an art teacher that I really look for. Then we get into the content. The content is delivered in a lot of different ways. It isn't necessarily all text. So there's video components, there's interactive elements, there's pictures, there's so many different things. Also resources, we have a lot of links within the text that you can click on and kind of take a virtual tour. There's also references on every page. So if you're interested in something that we mentioned on that specific page, at the bottom you'll find the references, not just at the end of the topic, but also in every single page. There's also activities that check your learning, which if you're using this as a training site for your librarians, I highly recommend you have them write their ideas within their activities. So for example, an activity might ask you a question and then there's a little blue box that says type your ideas here where you answer your question. But the best part is, and I found this very helpful as a graduate student, that I write my ideas and then I say save to my ideas. And then there's a section in Project Enable that you hit my ideas. And it collects all of your ideas in a long list. So it almost takes notes for you and categorizes all your ideas, which is a fantastic feature. If you're providing the training, then as the administrator, you would also be able to see, like my professors could see my ideas, could see my quiz scores, and I'll talk about quizzes later, but it's just a really great feature. And then every topic ends with a summary. So it's very short. We made sure not to make them really long. It just highlights the main ideas within that topic. After each topic is a list of references, but then it also gives you a quiz. The quizzes are generated from 30 questions, like a bank of 30 questions, and then 5 are randomly generated. So if you're doing this to test the knowledge of your librarians after they complete a topic, you can see their quiz scores. They can also retake the quizzes, and 5 new questions will be generated. So even if they retake it, they're not going to get the same questions that they got last time, which I thought was another really great feature. Preliminary and final assessments. So within Project Enable, there is a pre-test that you can take, but it does include all of the modules, not just Module 6, Targeting Autism. It is from all of the modules, which includes information on all disabilities. So you can take that, but it is not solely on autism. Then there is a final assessment that, again, includes all the modules, not just Module 6. I was talking to someone earlier about this, because they couldn't come today. I was talking to them yesterday, and they were like, it would be great to have something that was just Module 6. So that's going to be something I bring back to my team and see what we can do about it. These questions, it's a 30-question quiz, the final assessment, and it draws from the 30 bank of questions from every single module, every single topic. So the bank of questions it draws from is very, very large. So you can retake that also, and you'll always get new questions. So just to wrap this up, this has been an introduction to the new Targeting Autism in Libraries module as a part of Project Enable. We're currently pilot testing this. So we've asked teachers, librarians, students to go through Module 6 and then give us comments. If you are interested in piloting this, we are still looking for more people. So we would love, love, love if you could do that for us. So if you're interested, you can contact us, which I'll show you in a second how to do that. The official launch of the completed Targeting Autism in Libraries Learning Module will take place later this month. Now that I have all this great new information, I'm hoping it's still at the end of this month. But after I bring home all of this stuff, I'm assuming we will be hard at work to make it by the end of the month. Right now, Module 6 is open. It's live, which means this weekend you can access access it and preview it. We are going to close it tomorrow morning. So if you want to go back to your hotel rooms or on the plane on the way home, if you want to check it out, you still have time to do it, but it will be closed rather quickly while we're finishing up our last final touches. Other than that, please feel free to ask me any questions you have, but I'm going to be completely honest. I am probably not going to be able to answer all of them. I am not the expert. Dr. Ruth Small is. So you are welcome to ask me anything. You're welcome to email me. I'm sorry that color isn't great there. I cringe at that as an art teacher. But my email is klball@syr.edu. And you can also contact Dr. Ruth Small at drruth, so drruth@syr.edu. And I believe that's it. Are there any questions? Now you're scared to ask questions because I'm not going to know the answer.
Toward the end of the program.
I guess.
People are all questioned out. Thank you, Kate.